So now that we have seen that flat page tables can be quite large even for 32-bit address spaces and are too big to even fit in memory for 64-bit address spaces, let's talk about multi-level page tables, which is how we reduce the size of page tables when we have a large address space. So the problem with flat page tables is that their size is proportional to the address space, meaning how much memory can the application possibly address, not how much memory it is actually using. For a 32-bit address space, we have seen that we have a reasonably sized page table. So for 32-bit virtual addresses, the flat page table size is several megabytes. Note that we can have a very small application that only uses a couple of kilobytes of memory, yet it still needs a page table of this size, because the page table size has nothing to do with how much memory we are using, it has to do with how much memory can we possibly address. For 64-bit virtual addresses, a flat page table would simply be too big. The page table would be many, many gigabytes in size, so we simply cannot use it, because it wouldn't fit in the amount of physical memory we actually have. So multi-level page tables are designed to try to overcome both of the problems. We want the overall size of the page table to be proportional to how much memory we are using, and we want our page table to work even for 64-bit virtual addresses, as long as the program is actually not using the entire 64-bit virtual address space, which no program really does. The idea of why multi-level page tables work has to do with how the virtual address space is usually used by the applications. Recall that the application thinks it can address memory with 64-bit addresses, so it has this many potential memory locations it can access. But in reality, the application only allocates memory like this. At the beginning of the virtual memory, there is the code, the static variables, and the heap. And at the top of the virtual address space is the stack. So we're really talking about two contiguous regions of virtual memory that are actually used by the application. And even if these two are several gigabytes each, in a 64-bit address space, there will be many, many terabytes of unused address space here. But in a flat page table, we had to have a page table entry for each page in this huge space here. So a multi-level page table combines the idea of a flat page table, where we use some bits from the virtual address to index the table. This works really well in hardware. Hardware really likes using some bits to index some sort of an array. But we want to avoid the use of table entries that correspond to this, meaning we want to have a pretty normal page table-like thing here and here, but somehow not have anything for this so that we can simply omit those page table entries. Now that we have the idea for what we want, let's see how the multi-level page table is actually organized.